Chances are that if you're watching this video, you're tired of the hosting provider you have and you want to change to a different one. Well, I'm going to recommend you Hostinger. Now, the good part about it is that they offer free migration to new users and current users. So let's go check this out. The migration service from Hostinger is completely free, even for past or new users. All you do need is a hosting plan. So let me show you one really quickly that's a good deal. So jump into hosting, go into web hosting, and by the way, I'm providing the link in the description and a special coupon. Check out the deal that's going on. You can add this one or the one that you like, depending on the plan that you actually need. Okay, it's just been added to my card, and you can see it's selected by default 48 months because obviously that's the best pricing, plus you lock in the price for 48 months. If you need less, you can jump into 24, 12, or 1 month. Now, like I said, there's a special coupon code that I'm going to show you. You can see right here, the total is $143.52. And let's click on I have a coupon, type it in, SaaSmaster, and let's go ahead and apply it. You can copy the coupon code in the description also. Now it's $129.17, so don't miss out on that coupon. Now, how am I going to migrate? This is my Hostinger panel, and obviously I have my hosting plans here, and I need to migrate my site from another hosting provider. Well, it's easy. Go into Websites on the top menu, and you're gonna see here, Create or Migrate a Website. Let's create a migrate. I'm going to select the hosting plan. If you have several ones, select that you want to migrate that website or buy a new one. You can see get a new hosting plan. I'm selecting that one that I have. And you have two options, create a new website or migrate. We want to select migrate my website. And you have two options. You can upload the website. So if you have a file from a backup, you can actually do it from here. You'll have to have the file in zip or other formats. You can check it out. Let me go ahead and select it. You can see right here the formats, zip, tar, or GZ. GZ. And you'll grab that from the public underscore HTML folder, all right? But what if you don't have that? It's a little bit more complicated. You don't wanna go through all that hassle. You want them to help you out. Well, you have three options. You can import from WordPress, cPanel or WHM, or other control panels. Now be aware, there's some limitations in other control panels. Per se, Wix, they can't migrate from there. But aside from that, you can check with them in case you're not using WordPress or cPanel. Now, what if you have WordPress? You can use the WordPress login, so you provide it here, or use the link to backup files. In this case, we have the WordPress login, and I'm gonna do this site. Let me grab the link for this. It's one of my test sites, and I'll grab the username, okay, and the password. There we go, let's paste it here, and submit for request. Now, requests take, on average, less than 24 hours, so that's pretty cool, it's pretty fast. Because I think other hosting providers take longer and sometimes they don't even do it or they'll charge you for it. There we go. These are the next options that we have. Okay, so if you have a hosting plan with a domain included, you can go ahead and select claim a free domain. You can buy a domain in case you don't have one or use an existing domain that you have purchased from another provider. So in case you have a free domain, go ahead and select it. Search for a domain you might like. In this case, I won't do it. You can go ahead and search for it. If it's available, you can go select it. You can select from any of the extensions right here. Now, once you do that process, the migration is going to start and you're going to see this result. Let me go back because we're not gonna actually migrate that site. This is the one that I migrated previously, but you'll find the information here. You have two arrows, which is migration request. Let's go ahead and select it. And I have one of them here. You can see it's updated. And in case it hasn't finished or it's in progress, you'll see several type of messages available here. For example, check them out in case you need to resubmit it or if it's done or not. But it's super easy to do the migration with Hostinger. Now, things to consider with the Hostinger migration. First of all, it's free, even for past users. Second, there's no limitations on how much you want to import. So if the site is 100 gigabytes, no issues, they'll do it for you. But you do have to consider how much space your hosting plan has. I mean, if your hosting plan is 10 gigabytes and your site is 15, well, it's not gonna fit in there, okay? So those are the limitations in that sense. And they also provide migration of your domain from the past provider into Hostinger, and that's also for free. So that's pretty cool that they provide all of this. And basically, you put in the details and you sit back and relax and wait for them to finish the migration progress. But there you go. That is a wrap for Hostinger migration.